Hola, ¿qué tal amigos? Bienvenidos a Embemanía. Yo soy David Flores y continuando con esta serie de entregas sobre proyectos que promueven la adopción del blockchain y las criptomonedas en la vida diaria, que por cierto, pues ya estuvimos conversando sobre la nueva revolución que es este movimiento DeFi y también estuvimos conversando nuevamente sobre Brave y la criptomoneda BAT. Y hoy le corresponde el turno al proyecto Loli. Esta es una extensión que vas a instalar en tu navegador web para que cuando hagas compras por internet puedas recibir recompensas en Bitcoin. ¿Qué tal les parece? La verdad es que es muy interesante. Así que en esta entrega pues vamos a hacer un fácil tutorial para que puedas ganar Bitcoins mientras compras online y al final vamos a tener una entrevista con el fundador de Loli. Así que pues no se lo pierdan porque va a estar muy bueno. Si te gusta este video, regálanos un like, trata de compartirlo con todos tus amigos y suscríbete a nuestro canal para que formes parte de nuestra gran familia Invemanía. ¡Comencemos! Loli es realmente muy fácil de explicar y de utilizar porque funciona como muchas de las extensiones de este tipo que ya están disponibles en el mercado, como por ejemplo Honey o Ebates, que se utiliza mucho para estas compras en Amazon. Entonces, aquí pues cuando tú estás comprando, normalmente pues recibes recompensas o descuentos en puntos o en dinero. Entonces, por eso es que pienso que es muy fácil de explicar porque ya la mayoría de nosotros está familiarizado con este tipo de concepto y aquí la única diferencia es que en vez de puntos o dinero, pues vas a recibir Bitcoin, lo cual lo hace mucho más atractivo. Entonces, yo he estado utilizando el Loli en los dos computadores que tengo en la casa y desde los dos pues he estado haciendo compras, pues producto de estas compras en uno tengo, como ven ahí en pantalla, más o menos 3,504 satoshis, que es un equivalente a $32 al día de hoy, y en este computador en el que hago los videos de Invemanía tengo más o menos un equivalente a un dólar. Entonces he estado probando en los dos computadores porque pues uno es un Apple y el otro pues es un computador Dell, entonces como para probar qué tal funciona en los dos navegadores. Entonces la verdad pues estoy muy contento con este producto. Es una extensión, como les venía mencionando, fácil de utilizar. No necesitas saber ni de la tecnología detrás del Bitcoin o del blockchain para usarla, y desde la adopción, por eso para mí es lo más interesante, ya que ofrece como una tercera vía, ¿sí?, para ganar y usar Bitcoins, sobre todo para aquellas personas pues que no entienden mucho de la tecnología del blockchain o que no están interesadas en hacer trading o minería, y pues porque como estas son como las fuentes en estos momentos más comunes para interactuar con el Bitcoin o con el mercado cripto en general. Entonces es como esa tercera alternativa que pueden encontrar muchos usuarios para poder tanto recibir Bitcoins como luego también utilizarlos. Entonces ahí tiene una gran proyección. ¿Cómo instalarlo? En la descripción de este video o de este podcast vas a encontrar un link para que te lleve a la página de Loli, que es esta página como estás viendo ahí, a la página oficial, y de esta manera pues lo puedas descargar de forma segura. Entonces lo que vas a hacer es descargar ese parche o esa extensión, y este debo advertir, este es un link de referidos, así que podrás pues descargarlo entonces de forma segura y de paso apoyar nuestro canal, ya que pues con ese plan de referidos vamos a recibir $5 en Bitcoin luego de hacer la primera compra. De antemano pues obviamente les agradezco a todos como siempre por el apoyo a nuestro canal Invemanía. Así que luego que lo tengas instalado con nuestro enlace, pues la idea es que tú también puedas referir obviamente a tus amigos o a tus familiares con tu enlace para que tú también puedas ganarte esos Bitcoins, es decir, ese equivalente a $5 en Bitcoin. Entonces es muy atractivo ese programa. Muy bien, entonces la extensión está disponible tanto para Chrome, Safari y Mozilla en estos momentos. Alex Edelman, el CEO de Loli, me estuvo comentando en la entrevista que están trabajando en una futura extensión para el navegador Brave y para dispositivos móviles, así que pues espera un mayor nivel de uso. Entonces, supongamos que le das clic, ¿sí?, a ese link de referidos y vas directamente a la página de Loli, como ves por ejemplo en este caso, y lo que vas a hacer es, digamos que entonces utilizas este link y lo que haces es te lleva a una página directa como esta, y aquí vas a ver entonces esta opción que dice Get Loli for Chrome, o sea, descárgalo. Lo vas a descargar, vamos a hacerlo más bien en la en el navegador de Brave, que no lo tengo todavía instalado, como para que vean los pasos, que son realmente muy sencillos. Entonces le das clic ahí y esto te va a llevar como a, digamos, a a la tienda, ¿no? De Chrome. Sencillamente lo agregas, le das clic ahí y luego lo que vas a hacer es crear una cuenta nueva, ¿sí? Con tu correo electrónico y una contraseña. Entonces, una vez lo tengas instalado, le puedes dar clic y se va a desplegar una ventana de este tipo, que era la que les estaba mostrando. Aquí va a estar tu perfil, tu billetera, la cantidad que tienes y su equivalente en dólares, y aquí vas a poder copiar ese link de referidos que les venía mencionando. Pueden crear esa cuenta tanto con un correo electrónico o también lo pueden hacer con la cuenta de Facebook. Eso ya depende de cada persona. Aquí vas a ver, digamos, el historial de compras que tienes y también lo vas a poder hacer incluso en la página de internet de Loli, pero eso ya posteriormente ustedes, digamos, pueden explorarlo. Aquí puedes ver, por ejemplo, cómo te lleva directamente a la página de Loli y puedes ver tu cuenta. Entonces está el equivalente en Bitcoin y en dólares y la actividad que he tenido. Entonces, qué es lo que he estado comprando y cuánto he recibido por esas compras, tu cuenta, etcétera. Ya ustedes pueden explorar todo esto. Pero entonces, supongamos que ya lo tienen instalado y que quieren hacer una compra online y usar pues Loli para poder ganarse los Bitcoins. Entonces, tienes dos alternativas. Número uno, puedes ir a la página donde deseas hacer la compra. Entonces, por ejemplo, puedes ir a la página de Walmart, de Jet, de Priceline, etcétera. Ellos tienen alrededor es decir, más de 500 negocios vinculados con Loli, así que pues es muy fácil que encuentres una tienda que esté vendiendo el producto o el servicio que estás buscando en ese momento. Entonces supongamos que vamos a la tienda de Gap, queremos comprar, no sé, una camisa, una camiseta, para el papá, sí, para el Día del Padre, por dar una idea. Entonces ves cómo se activa acá de una vez el botón, digamos, el circulito morado se torna rojo. Eso significa que te está enviando una señal diciendo: mucha atención, esta página está vinculada con nosotros, entonces lo que debes hacer es activarlo para que tengas un descuento entre un 0.5% y un 3.5% en Bitcoin, ¿sí? Entonces vas a recibir eso. Entonces, como ves, ya le doy clic y queda completamente activado. Son fluctuaciones, es decir, entre un 0.5 y un 3.5, porque eso va a depender del tipo de producto. Hay unos productos que tienen más descuento que otros, como en cualquier otra tienda, en cualquier otro negocio. Entonces, ves cómo ya se torna verde, ¿sí? Digamos, si me paso para otra página, se torna morado y ahí se torna verde. Eso significa que ya está activado, que puedes comprar tranquilamente en la tienda. Entonces, ahí puedes ver cómo efectivamente vas teniendo diferentes tipos de descuento. Ahora, la otra alternativa que tienes es que sencillamente puedes ir directamente a la página de loli.com, ¿sí? Y vas a la, digamos, cantidad de almacenes que tienes. Entonces, aquí en el banner superior, vas aquí donde dice Shop, le das clic ahí. Y vas a ver cómo está toda la cantidad de tiendas. Entonces, si estás buscando, por ejemplo, Walmart, le das clic a Walmart y le das sencillamente ahí, en donde dice Shop, te lleva entonces, te dice, bueno, ya está activado y te lleva directamente a la tienda. Entonces, como ves, es muy sencillo. Lo puedes hacer directamente con la página de la tienda donde estás buscando o a través de Loli. Cualquiera de las dos vías funciona, pues, y lo único que les recomiendo es que para asegurarse que efectivamente está activado, ¿sí? Que este botoncito esté efectivamente verde y no morado o rojo, pues para que ya ustedes puedan hacer su compra tranquilamente sabiendo que van a obtener esas recompensas. Una vez ustedes tengan $15 acumulados en Bitcoin, pues van a poder enviarlo a cualquier billetera de Bitcoin para que pues tú lo puedas utilizar para lo que quieras, inversiones, etcétera. Entonces, como ves, pues es realmente muy práctico para usar en tus compras y lo mejor es que es completamente gratis, no necesitas poner dinero para comenzar a ganar. Es sencillamente instalarlo, crear una cuenta y comenzar a comprar. Dos puntos finales antes de la entrevista. Número uno, actualmente por ser un proyecto muy nuevo, pues está disponible solamente para el mercado de los Estados Unidos, pero hablando con el CEO, él me estuvo comentando que están en planes de expansión para, digamos, para más adelante abrir nuevos mercados. Eso va a implicar obviamente un nivel de logística, de buscar nuevas tiendas en esos países que efectivamente quieran y estén interesados en funcionar dentro de este sistema de recompensas. defensas de Bitcoin, pero pues en la medida en que ellos, este piloto les esté funcionando como efectivamente, exitosamente ha sido hasta este punto en el mercado americano, muy seguramente se van a estar expandiendo en otros países. Segundo, están trabajando también en una billetera, en una aplicación que va a estar disponible tanto para los iPhones como para los Androids, donde van a ofrecer muchos más servicios, no solamente este tipo de recompensas. Entonces pues van a tratar de variar en el tipo de interacciones que pueden tener los usuarios con los bitcoins que van ganando. Entonces está muy interesante también por ese lado. Y como siempre, pues yo voy a estar avisándoles sobre las nuevas noticias que vayan surgiendo sobre Loli. Muy bien, esto es todo lo que tenía para compartirles en esta primera parte sobre el fácil tutorial acerca de Loli. Y ahora sí pasemos a la conversación que tuve con Alex Edelman. Él es el cofundador de Loli. Y como el diálogo está en inglés, pues lo que les recomiendo es sencillamente, para un mejor entendimiento, darle clic acá a esta opción de subtítulos para que ya queden activados. Entonces, ahora ya que estamos todos listos, comencemos. Alex, thank you so much for accepting the invite and I mean to our channel and spreading the word about Loli with our Latino community.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
To start, please share with us a little bit about your background and what were you doing before Loli and how Loli was created.
Yeah, so my name's Alex. I'm the founder, co-founder of Loli and CEO of Loli. And yeah, we started this venture about a year ago, but our team and I, we started building together about 7 years ago. So Matt, my co-founder, we were both in North Carolina and we wanted to solve this problem of the democratization of commerce. How do we give everyone in the world the ability to be connected through commerce? How can I go send payments cross-border? How can I go buy things cross-border? I think that the world would be a better place if we were connected, not divided. And so when we were building this, we thought it looked like an e-commerce gateway. We thought that it was a buy button that gave everybody in the world the ability to buy anywhere. And we solved a big part of that, and we built a really cool company called Cosmic over about the course of about 6 years or 7 years or so. We ended up getting acquired by our biggest customer, which was PopSugar, to come in and power $1.2 billion in retail revenue. Wow. At ShopStyle. And then we ended up later getting acquired again by a bigger company called Ebates. And what Ebates is a massive cashback company. And Ebates came along and they bought us away. And so we got to really learn the cashback model. And then I think about like 5-6 years ago, I had learned about Bitcoin and I was just fascinated with it because it had the same mission that my team and I were out building. And that was to connect everybody through commerce, connect everybody through one currency. So I got really excited by that because it was native to the currency. Nobody controls it. It just is. And there's a public database of exactly how it works. And it got us really excited. So our whole team got really excited about it. I sent it back, to my mom, to my dad. I tried to get them involved. They didn't listen. I wanted to teach people about like why it was so important. So yeah, that's how I kind of got involved in Bitcoin and involved in commerce. And then after we parted ways with Ebates, we ended up starting a company called Loli, which we're building now, which gives people Bitcoin back instead of cash back when you shop online at almost 1,000 different merchants.
So yeah, I guess it's kind of like, for you it was kind of easy because Ebates has a similar business model, right? So it was pretty easy to put everything together, like Bitcoin one side and the other, kind of like rewards program. And I mean, that's the boom, that I'm seeing there. Moving forward, let me tell you a little bit about my experience with Loli. I've been using the extension for a while, but recently me and my wife, we moved in a new house. And when you move a new house, you wanted to have new stuff, right? So we wanted to buy a new sofa. And so since I knew that she loved, using apps for rewards, or discounts like Ebates or Groupons or even Honey, but she doesn't understand a little bit or that much about Bitcoin or blockchain. She hasn't even, bought Bitcoin yet. So I saw this situation and I saw a really great opportunity to show her that she can have Bitcoin really easy, like not going to, you know, a exchange platform and buying and probably risk her money. So we purchased the sofa on Yet, I mean, one of the merchants that you guys have, and using the extension. So she got, you know, by that time, the equivalent, I guess, like $30 in Bitcoin. And a week later, she saw, like, she checked the extension and, I mean, her account, and she, I mean, with the same Bitcoin amount, was like around $45. So she got excited and she said, like, forget about the other apps. I'm going to start, you know, using this extension, and let's only use Loli from now on. So this is one of the reasons why I got very excited about Loli, because I'm always, you know, eager to find crypto projects that provide adoption in daily needs or real life, you know, like things that you can actually see and you don't have to go through all the technology behind that. So I think this is the right way to have a massive use and, you know, volume in the future, like we're trying to find. So I'm telling you all this personal story because I would like to know from you, I mean, like your experience, how it's actually trying to explain somebody, you know, about Bitcoin or blockchain, and how was Loli helping in that matter? Like how you can connect these things and trying to make all these blockchain and Bitcoin easier for a regular person.
So first off, I love that story. And we hear that story over and over again. It's kind of funny. I feel like couples are introducing it to each other because they're like, if you're going to go buy that couch, I at least want to earn Bitcoin back on the couch. Or if you're going to go buy makeup, or if you're going to go buy that new TV or whatever it is, why not earn Bitcoin back on it? And so it really, like, you know, we don't encourage anyone to buy anything that they don't need, but everybody buys stuff, and a lot of people buy things online. And so it takes something that somebody already knows, which is earning cash back, and it makes it really, really easy for them to earn Bitcoin back in a very similar fashion. So I think the psychology, like, you nailed it. Like, that's the exact psychology. That's what's happening. And when we first launched, Bitcoin was at 3,600. Now Bitcoin is around 8,000. And so a lot of our users went from, like, earning at a lower amount, and then now it's at a higher amount. And so our average percent back that we give across the board is 7%. So they effectively, like, most of our users have earned around 15 to 16% back. And a lot of the cashback companies cannot compete with that. Like, you know, they're not, they don't have a currency that's going up and down and has the volatility.
I mean, you don't have reward points that, you know, go higher over time. I mean, they don't go up.
Yeah, exactly. And I love that you called it reward points, because that's how we got all these merchants on board. I went to all the merchants that I had met over the last 7 years, and everywhere, North America, Europe, everywhere. And I wanted to see, like, how many of them, you know, we could get on board and how many of them would adopt Bitcoin. And at first, you know, we were getting some, you know, strange, like, people were like, okay, I don't know about this whole Bitcoin thing. But then I was in a meeting, I think it was with Priceline, and someone from the team was like, oh, so he was like a junior level person. And he just sort of, like, got really excited, and he chimed in and he said, so it's like international points but you guys don't control the value. And I was like, yes, that sounds right. And then I started to use that for everyone. I was like, yeah, like, if we were in you know, Mexico, if we were in Canada, if we were in anywhere, everybody's Bitcoin is the same. And that's the beautiful thing about it, is, like, everyone can be connected through this one currency, this one point system. And that point system also looks like it's a store of value, and it also looks like a medium of exchange as well. So a lot of the merchants got really excited about that. And we are about to hit 1,000 merchants now. We have Walmart, Priceline, Booking, Best Buy, you name it. We have them on board.
I mean, I think, like, a big part of the market right now, it's still about trading and mining. And I think projects like Loli can provide, like, a kind of like a third way, right? To people that don't understand, they don't really want to trade, or they don't want to buy a mining rig, you know, to start that business. So you think that this is the future for this market, like, having companies that can attract these type of people, or the people, I mean, like, users that really like the blockchain, but they don't want to trade, they don't want to mine?
Exactly. So I think that when, you know, when Bitcoin first came out, in order to get it, you had to mine it. And mining is very confusing. Like, I mean, I don't mine, you know, I'm interested in it, and I used to just, you know, mine on my computer, but it's not really that efficient if you don't have a high powered, expensive computer rig. And I just don't think that the average consumer, is going to do it. And it just doesn't make sense for a lot of people with the economics of, you know, energy and everything. So the next phase was investing. And I think if Bitcoin is going to get mass adoption, it's not going to be through investing, because even investing in stocks, which are way safer, better in some cases, safer investment is what I should say, because it's less volatile. Even stocks, like probably 1% of the world or less, invest in stocks. So if you're going to take this asset, which looks like a more volatile, riskier stock, and you say, hey, everybody, convert all your currency and invest in this very volatile stock, I don't think that the world's going to adopt, the masses are not going to adopt that. Now, if you take something that I could say almost literally, if you're an adult, you shop. People buy things. You get groceries. You have to get food to eat. You have to, you know, pay rent. You have to travel at some point, take the bus, whatever it is. Everybody has to spend things. I personally think that the best way to distribute Bitcoin over time is to take little bits off of from merchants, and for merchants to encourage people to earn Bitcoin, for us to encourage people to earn Bitcoin when they're doing something that they would do anyway, which is shop online.
Yeah, that's absolutely right. And I think that's the key of Loli. Like, you're not putting users to do something different, just doing what they do typically at home, you know, and is shopping online. So what are currently the most popular merchants in Loli? Like,
so some of our most popular are Walmart, Jet has been super popular. I personally
two of my favorite ones, actually.
Yeah, they're great, because yeah. It's like an everyday purchase. So we really like those two partners. And then so Jet, I think 9 months ago, I completely dropped Amazon personally, and completely dropped Prime and shopped exclusively at Jet just to sort of see. And I haven't looked back. So I've stacked a lot of sats personally from shopping at Jet and Walmart. Groceries I get from Jet. That's been really great. And then Caviar for food delivery. I think it's trycaviar.com has been great. We're about to launch a really big food delivery service in the next couple of weeks, so stay tuned for that. And then Priceline and booking.com have been two of our biggest. Marriott, Hilton have been really big for travel. Hotwire, Groupon, Macy's has been great, and SeatGeek for games. So games and concerts, like live music, mm-hmm. Going to watch basketball, like whatever people are into, that's been awesome. Foot Locker for shoes, and then for beauty, Ulta, Sephora have been awesome as well. So yeah, those are some of our top ones that just come to mind. But if you put a link in the below, loli.com/stores, to see a list of all of our merchants.
Yeah, you're going to see all of them. Yeah. So now let's talk about the technical support. So I understand that Loli is available on Chrome, Firefox, and Safari. Are we expecting Loli probably in Brave? So, because I mean, you know, Brave is one of the browsers that the crypto community use, I think, the most, and also the apps. I mean, for mobile apps, are we expecting that anytime soon as well?
I would love to. I've been talking with the Brave team. It's a little bit more difficult, because in order for Loli to work, we need to be able to communicate with the merchant. And what a lot of people don't realize is that Brave actually stops that communication by shutting down that cookie. And there's good cookies and there's bad cookies in the way that technologies communicate on through the browser. So when we try to communicate with Walmart to say, hey, this user is shopping at this site, we can't communicate with Walmart, and then the purchase gets lost. So we're trying to work through a way to get covered through that. Yeah, right now Chrome, Safari, and Firefox are the preferred method for people to earn Bitcoin. You can earn Bitcoin if you don't have a desktop. You can earn Bitcoin on your mobile phone. You just have to be logged in, and you can press through It's not as good of an experience, but we are going to launch a mobile app probably in the next 6 to 9 months that will let people more seamlessly earn Bitcoin when they shop on mobile.
Okay, so with that, future app or tentative app, are we expecting to have like a non-custodial wallet to provide more services to the users?
I love that question. So it's our duty to educate the consumer on owning your own keys, on why Bitcoin is so important, and being having a self-sovereign banking system. Mm-hmm. So I think in order to do that, it starts with like actually giving them a custodial wallet. Because I've been trying to teach my mom about private keys and stuff. And it's just it's not going to happen for some time. Someone has to really understand it. And my mom's really smart, and that's not to discredit her by any means. But I think in order to take Bitcoin to the masses, you can't start with a non-custodial wallet. It took me a while to really educate my friends and everything on why that's so important. So I think we start with a custodial wallet, which is what we have now. And then over time, we do a non-custodial wallet that will let people actually transfer their Bitcoin into different wallets over time.
So now that probably we have all our community excited with our conversation about Loli, I think one of the big questions they might have right now is when Loli will be available in other countries and what would be the first markets?
Yeah, so I'm really excited to expand. I mean, Bitcoin is inherently global. We have global demand. And so I want to get Loli to as many countries as possible, as quickly as possible. And so I'm really excited to expand. The most demand right now has come from Canada. I think that's probably going to be our next test market or our first test market. And then we're going to look to our community to expand from there. So I'm all ears. We've built our product around our user. So I want people to request their country, and I want that to determine where we go next and where we develop partners next. So would love to get to Latin America as soon as possible. I'm half Mexican. I want to get it to my my Mexican family, and I want them to have Bitcoin, and I want them to be able to earn it really easily. So I'm biased there, but I definitely want to expand to as many countries as possible.
Yeah, that would be awesome, because I know, in Latin America, we will have, we shop a lot, so of course you're going to have a lot of users and customers willing to use Loli. So what are the goals for Loli by the end of this year, and how do you see your company in 5 years? What are the plan?
So I really want to give people the ability to buy and sell Bitcoin over time. I want to give people the ability to learn and about Bitcoin. I think that one of the things that's lacking in the space is education. And I think you're doing an incredible job. I think it's so necessary for people to be creating intelligent videos and having smart interviews, asking great questions, and opening that up to the community. So I think you guys are part of this future, and I'm so excited for channels like this that are making Bitcoin accessible to more people. So I would love to help with the education side, whether that's through sponsorships, doing our own podcast, doing our own newsletters to get this thing to more people. I also think giving people the ability to buy and sell Bitcoin, having a non-custodial wallet, we're going to be getting into mobile very soon. That's going to be helpful for people that have web, where they're buying most of their online purchases, and also mobile, where they're going and getting their coffee every day and earning Bitcoin on that, or going to a restaurant because they get Bitcoin back. That's the sort of experience that I think you need to make Bitcoin a part of someone's everyday life. And then I think there's some really interesting ways that you can involve credit. If you can give everybody the unbanked credit, I think that's the massive game that how do you give everyone in the world what Visa gives only the wealthy, or Amex gives only the wealthy? What if everybody had opportunity to have credit and on-chain credit? So there's infinite possibilities when you really have the wallet that people want and love. And we start with rewards, and I think that's a great place to start. Make people love Bitcoin, make people earn more. I think that's the exciting part right now. I think it's really exciting over the next 15, 20 years.
Wow, it's been an exciting conversation. Alex, thanks again for this interview, and I look forward to talk to you again, in the future, to give us more news about this excited project called Loli, and probably, you know, some of the new companies that you can mention right now.
Yeah, so thank you so much for having me, and look forward to staying in touch, and let me know if I can be helpful with anything in the future.
All right, thanks, Alex. Alex, bye-bye.
All right, take care.